Good morning, children. I hope you can hear me. Welcome to the online classes continuation. I hope I am audible to all of you. Please show your hands, thumbs up, so that I can start. Children, I'll be continuing math class. Previous, I was teaching you science. Now, I'll be teaching you math this period. Okay? Till the last class, Ma'am Roshi was teaching you math. She taught you about integers. Today we will discuss fractions, introduction of fractions. I hope you are audible. I am audible to you. Show your hands so that I can. Okay. Wait for 2-3 minutes. I am admitting all. By the time we will start. Okay, children, the topic, fraction. I hope all of you are ready with your copy. Ma'am said you to keep the copy ready, book ready. Book is not at present. I'm just revising the topic, fraction, which you are expected to know. The previous knowledge about fractions, I will be discussing today. So I will be teaching you science and math both. So this period is of math. All right, children. Okay, children. We'll start the class. Now, first of all, the meaning of fractions. Now, the need of fractions. What was the need of having this particular term in math? For example, look at the figure. A circle which is divided into 4 equal parts. Now, the part which is shaded portion, if I want to express this circle is divided into 4 equal parts, out of this, I have to express this shaded portion. So it could be expressed as 1 out of 4. So the need of fraction is to express a part of a whole. Actually, the whole circle is 4 upon 4. It is divided into 4 parts and 4 upon 4. That is complete whole. Now, if I want to express only the shaded portion, there comes the need of fractions. 1 upon 4. There are 4 equal parts. Out of that, 1 part is shaded. Now, similarly, if I want to express the unshaded part, 3 upon 4. Situations like this arises the need of fractions. Now, if you consider a fraction, it has the numerator denominator. If you check into any fraction, it has two parts, numerator as well as denominator. Now, types of fractions. fractions can be grouped into three major categories. First, all of you know it also, you have learned it in the junior classes, proper fraction. Fractions whose numerator is smaller than the denominator. For example, 2 upon 5. The numerator is smaller than the denominator. These kinds of fractions are called proper fractions. Always, the value of a proper fraction is less than 1. Value of a proper fraction is always less than 1. Then second, improper fractions. I hope I am audible to all of you. Just show your hands. Thumbs up. Ritima Vijay, switch on your video. Ritima, I hope you are. I am audible to you. Then second kind of fractions. Second kind of fractions, improper fractions. It is as simple, just opposite of this. If the numerator is bigger, for example, 3 upon 2. Fractions with the numerator is greater than the denominator is called improper fractions. Now, the value of improper fraction is always greater than 1. Value of improper fraction is always greater than 1. Then, mixed fractions. Mixed fractions, for example, 1 upon 2. That is, it has a complete whole along with a fraction. So the value of mixed fraction is always greater than 1 because there will be a complete whole followed by whole number followed by an improper fraction. For example, 1 upon 2. 3, 1 upon 4, etc. This is simple classification of fraction on the basis of numerator and denominator. And repeating once more, the need of fractions, certain situation, we need to express the part of a whole. There arises the need of fraction. Then, fraction has two parts, numerator and denominator. Now, on the basis of numerator, denominator, fractions can be classified into proper fractions, improper fractions, and mixed fractions. Now, the meaning of proper fraction, where the numerator is smaller than the denominator. Always, the value of proper fraction is less than 1. Come to improper fraction. Improper fraction has numerator bigger than the denominator. And the value of improper fraction is greater than 1. Now, you have mixed fractions. Mixed fractions have a complete whole. That is a whole number, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., followed by a fraction. 3, 1 upon 2, 1, 1 upon 2, etc., etc. Now, Swarit Bharadwaj, what happened to you? You are feeling uneasy. Swarit, switch on your video. Aditya Panjwani. Switch on your video. Arjun Rati, can you hear me? Show your thumbs up. Okay. Now, I was discussing you about types of fractions. Then come to representation of fractions on number line. Now, I told you the meaning of types of fractions. Now, we can express fractions on number line. You have learned about number line in the 6th class, how to express whole numbers on the number line. For example, this is the number line 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. This is a representation of whole numbers on the number line. Now, situations, we need to express fractions on the number line. Now, all fractions can be expressed on the number line. For example, I'm taking 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4 is an improper fraction. So, it's a proper fraction. It can be expressed on the number line. What is we do is between 0 and 1. Look at this segment. Between 0 and 1, divide it into 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Alright, children. The segment between 0 and 4. Divide it into 1, 2, 3, 4 equal parts. As the denominator indicates, the first part is called 1 upon 4. Second part is called 2 upon 4. Third part is called 3 upon 4. So this is 3 upon 4 on the number line, this point. And this, where 1, that is 4 upon 4. And take another example. Five upon seven. Express 5 upon 7 on the number line. All of you write this question. You have the copy. Write the heading, revision fractions, and write a question. Represent 5 upon 7 on number line. Okay? Please do write in your copy. Represent 5 upon 7 on number line. Draw a number line first. Alright? Express between 0 and 7. 0 and 1. Draw this number line 0 and 1. Divide this into 7 equal parts. 7 equal parts. This 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. You can do by simply by marking theoretically. We are not doing it exact measurement. Alright, so what have we done here? Draw the segment and represent 0 and 1 on the number line. Between 0 and 1, divide it into 7 equal parts. Now, why the 7? Because the denominator here is 7. And what was the question? Represent 5 upon 7 on number line. Now, between 0 and 1, 7 equal parts approximately. Now start counting the fifth part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now show this point by your pencil or pen different color. This is 5/7. Alright, children. This is how to represent proper fractions on the number line. Now, I'll take example of an improper fraction. For example, 7/3. 7/3. First, convert it into mixed fraction. You learn the conversion by dividing 7. 2 whole number, 1/3. Alright children, 7/3 can be written as 2 1/3. Representing odd number line, the question represent 7/3 odd number line. So what we do? 0, 1, 2. This is after 2. So between 2 and 3, divide this segment into 3 equal parts. As the 3. 1, 2, and 3. So this point will be 2 1/3. That is equal to 7/3. Alright children, how to represent improper fractions on the number line. Draw the number line. For example, 7/3. Convert it into mixed fraction after division. Between 2 and 3 it is. So divide between 2 and 3 into 3 equal parts. The first part after 2 1/3, that is 7/3. So like this, every fraction can be expressed on the number line. So that is the procedure of doing number line with respect to fraction. Now, there is another topic called equivalent fractions. Look at these two fractions, 2/4, 1/2. 2/4 and 1/2. The numeric value of both these fractions are equal. They are called equivalent fraction. Look at here. Represent this circle shaded portion on the shaded portion with the help of fraction 1/2. This shaded portion on the 2/4. But if you look into this, numerically both are equal. Such as fractions are called equivalent fraction. We get equivalent fractions. For example, 1/2, you multiply the same number numerator and denominator. Or same number 3. So like this, we can get as many equivalent fractions by multiplying, and or it can be dividing also. So what is the actual meaning of equivalent fractions? both of them, they are having the same numeric representation, same numeric value, equal numeric value. So that is equivalent fractions. Now, comparison of fractions. Comparison of fractions with the same denominator. I am discussing that only for the time being. 2 upon 3, 4 upon 3, 1 upon 3, and 7 upon 3. All these are having the same denominator. So in the similar way, 7 upon 3, 7 is greater than, then 4 upon 3, then 2 upon 3, then 1 upon 3. Okay? The comparison of fractions, first what you have to check, the denominator should be same. Alright children, I will discuss about comparison of fractions with a different denominator in the next class. Okay children, so we will revise or we will just go through what we have learned. Fractions, the meaning of fraction, when we want to express the part of a whole, there we need the fractions. Second, types of fractions, proper fraction, improper fraction, and mixed fractions. Then next I talk to you about representation of fractions on the number line. Now finally I said how to compare fractions where the denominators are equal. Alright children, then I'll give you some questions for homework. The same copy ma'am told you to write, in that you write certain question. Pause. Define improper fraction. Give one example. Second, represent 4 upon 3 on number line. Question number 3, compare Alright children, these three questions, you do it in the copy. I hope you understood what I have told all these. This is just a revision. Don't worry, we will do the regular classes later. I hope all of you are keeping safe. Okay, wait for a few minutes more. Let me have the attendance taken. After that, I will leave the class. I am taking the attendance for the time being. Please wait. Anything you want to ask, you can ask. This section, that is 7C and 7B. Anyone, those who want to ask anything, you can put your hands up. Yes, Mansi, speak. Mansi, speak.
So, हमें ये मतलब
कॉपी में लाउडर
आपने होमवर्क किया
है? I can't hear you. Little more louder. Speak. Mansi, speak. Mansi, unmute yourself.
हाँ,
यस
पिक सो हमें होमवर्क कॉपी में करना है
हाँ द सेम कॉपी मैम टोल्ड यू ना इन दैट डू इट ओके वेल रिधिमा एनी प्रॉब्लम रिधिमा रिधिमा यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग आई थिंक यू आर क्लियर एनीबडी एल्स फ्रॉम दिस ग्रुप देवांश बंसल कनिष्का अवनी अनिष्का चिराग विधि एनी प्रॉब्लम अनम्यूट योर सर विधि अनम्यूट योर सर same denominator comparison means without number line you do simply looking at the numerator no simply by comparing the numerator Nandini unmute yourself Nandini unmute yourself Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Can you please explain the comparison of fractions again?
Comparison of fractions with the same denominator. Nandini?
Yes, sir.
Same denominator. Same denominator. Different denominator I will tell you in the next class. For example, 1 upon 3, 4 upon 3, 7 upon 3, 8 upon 3. Denominators are same. Just look into the numerator. 8 is greater than 7. So, 8 upon 3 is greater than 7 upon 3. That concept is used. Nandini, simply look into the numerator. I will discuss about different denominators in the next class. Vidhi, anything you want to ask? Unmute yourself. No. Yuyutsu, unmute yourself. Unmute.